What's going on, everyone? My name is Lucas, and today we're talking about the Polish striker who's currently the top goal scorer in Serie A. So, how do you pronounce his name?
Oh, Piatek.
But that man, once again, Piatek!
Guys, let's do a pronunciation. Piatek. Me and you are pronouncing this, right?
Yes.
Oh my God.
It's
pronounced Piatek.
Piatek. So,
the start of Krzysztof Piątek's Serie A career has gone as well as it can get. However, this guy was a complete unknown to fans outside of Poland. Heck, I'm Polish, and I thought I knew a little bit about Polish prospects, but I'll be honest, I never heard of this guy until he made his move to Genoa. If you look on Wikipedia, it's the most basic page you can write, and there's not much more on the Polish version. So let's learn about this guy. Krzysztof Piątek was born in Jerzoniów, Poland on July 1st, 1995. His youth football was played there with Dziewiątka Jerzoniów and later with Lechia Jerzoniów. He made his debut with the latter club when he was 17 in the 4th division of Polish football, and in 2014 he moved to Zagłębie Lubin. His time at Zagłębie Lubin wasn't ideal. He was a Polish youth international, but wasn't getting it done on the pitch. He played a lot of matches in the Polish second tier and Ekstraklasa with them, but his scoring record was nothing to write home about. His contract was running down, and the club tried to agree to a new contract. However, they weren't willing to offer the wages, which was reported to be over 10,000 zloty a week, which is a little bit more than 2,000 euros. Apparently, he didn't want to stay there, and Lubin were fine with letting him go, although the coach was disappointed. That was Piotr Stokowiec, who could only say good things about the young striker. With 18 goals, 9 assists, and 88 appearances, Lubin decided to sell him for reportedly half a million euros to Cracovia. So the next step for Piątek was to go to Kraków and score goals. Sounds simple enough. Now Lubin wouldn't regret this transfer because they did better than Cracovia in the seasons without Piątek, but they did miss out on a lot of goals and money. After his first season with Cracovia, he scored 11 and assisted 2 in 27 matches. Now let's jump to 2018, where in January, he could have left in the winter transfer period. However, he was willing to wait and work hard for the rest of the season. This proved to be the right move to stay with Cracovia, as he ended up with 21 goals in 36 matches, including a brace against his former club. The summer of 2018 arrived, and there were plenty of offers on the table for Krzysztof Piątek. After a successful spell, it was the right time to leave. In a recent interview, he said he got offers from every single top league. In the end, he joined Genoa, as Serie A is one of the strongest leagues in the world, and Polish players have done well in that league. Even with that being said, he knew he still had a lot to learn and develop as a player. Something else that convinced him to join Genoa is that they have a track record of playing young strikers. Pietro Pellegri and Giovanni Simeone were two he mentioned in the same interview, I believe, and Genoa ended up selling them for a good amount of money. He did comment that he had offers from bigger clubs than Genoa, but he wanted to be at a club where he wouldn't be sitting on the bench most of the time. Funnily enough, in a different interview when he was at Cracovia, he was asked where he sees himself in 2 years. His response was in top league, maybe Italy or Spain. So now this part of the video I've had to redo again because this guy keeps on scoring. I know it's early, but it looks like Krzysztof has made the right choice to join Genoa. He's now gotten 8 goals in 6 Serie A matches and 12 goals in 6 matches in all competitions. That's 9 goals in 7 Serie A matches now, 13 in all competitions. Guy just can't stop. Now you could have sensed this coming since his preseason he was performing quite well and scoring a lot of goals. Now with that continuing into league play, what other Serie A strikers from the past have had great starts to their seasons? Now Milito, he had 5 goals for Genoa in his first 6 matches. R9 Ronaldo for AC Milan, he had 5. Diabate for Benevento of all teams had 7 in his first 6 games. And Shevchenko also had 7 when he started out with Milan. There's only been one other guy who's had 8 goals in 6 Serie A matches, and that was way back in 1949-1950, where a guy named Carl Agi Hansen. Yeah, everyone knows who that is, right? Yeah, I don't, but it just shows how insane this is, really. Another thing I'd mention is an Instagram post I saw from IFTV. They translated something from Gazzetta dello Sport, where Gazzetta described him as, he's got the spirit of Milito with the instinct of Inzaghi. He's a mix of both. Not a bad mix, if you ask me. Whether he keeps this up for the whole season is unlikely, but why can't he have a great season? Obviously, he's already having a fantastic season. During Shevchenko's debut season, he had 24 and 32 matches, so it'll be interesting if he can get close to that. He's 16 away, so it's possible. I do remember reading in another interview that he says he wants to score in every single match and will work hard every day. Obviously, every striker wants that, and to be fair to him, he's done that so far. So I hope he keeps it up, but obviously that isn't realistic. However, it's not often that you see a player from the Polish leagues having such an instant impact like this. But for now, it's up to Krzysztof to keep on improving and surprising his opponents. Genoa have a good track record with strikers, like I mentioned earlier, and so far, Krzysztof seems like he's next in line. So it's been great for Piontek so far, but I wonder who'll be the first to be stupid enough to link him to Barcelona.
Well, I guess it's everyone. Well, have a great day, everyone.